chat thing is sideways. I'm interested to see if the chat goes literally sideways, because my phone's like not turning the right way for some stupid fucking reason. I love it when technology does things like that, when it's so fucking trash. And then we're going to have Streamlabs issues, you wait. Watch me have Streamlabs issues. Watch me have fucking Streamlabs issues. I predict it now. Really funny. A wonderful anecdote. He gets paid money to say that on national radio. It's a bit icy out there. Yeah, bro, it's -3. What? What is this shit, bro?
For someone they don't like. Well, I mean, what sort of a sick mind would do this? And then I'd...
Oh, it's James O'Brien. You're a fucking cunt, bruv. You're a literal cunt. That guy's a complete cunt. Complete fucking living in a fucking dream wet blanket dumb cunt. Fact. Shout out James O'Brien, LBC. Piece of shit. I hope you slip on the ice and crack your fucking neck. True story. It's alright, I don't care about toxicity. It'll be fine. Classical.
The wild dogs cry out in the night as they grow restless, longing for some solitary company. I know that I must do what's right, sure as Kilimanjaro rises like Olympus above the Serengeti. To cure what's deep inside, frightened of this thing that I've become.
bit. That bit.
Across London. This is Smooth Radio.
No.
One, two. And your dog's not low. Every dog got his day. Needless to say. With a chief of witness with a cats wanna play. I told you, that's a run. That cash is fair. Stretch my heat and make you do a pot of parade. Pick your ball. Melee, pick I'm doing ballet. Dropping Dante. Brought again, Broadway. Get applause like a matador. Crap. Hey, who the hell? Play.
Can't do that. Stream's not working. I don't think.
Let's go, let you score your roll money, let me put on my screws.
There we go.
Paranoid at the things I say. Wondering what's the penalty from day to day. I'm hanging out, partying with girls that never die. Skills picking on my eyes, my campaign telling lies. I was just spreading my love, didn't know my love. What's the
terrible single?
But it's all good as long as I'm stuck together now in the hood.
Shit. Shit signal. And people wonder why radio's dead. Because no one's fucking listening and the signal's fucking trash everywhere. Even on an FM channel. Like, really shit. That's how bad. This one ain't, though.
Yeah, the phone lines up and
this one's perfect.
As always. 07908 340811.
Someone text them and shout out Big Up Sparks One, yeah?
Come and find us on Facebook, search for The Garage House. Instagram, TikTok.
Instagram and TikTok.
Our sole purpose to bring you genuine underground vibes. None of that commercial business.
None of that commercial business.
You. Except all the garage and house crew.
Absolutely all the garage and house crew.
From Brentwood.
From Brentwood, hey!
We got two, Mr. Richard Creek. Brennan Samuel. Mr. Larry Devine, wicked to meet you the other day, mate.
Nearly home.
We got two, Mr. Steve O.
Fuck me. What's the snow still? Icy river today. Oh my God, she got delivery for me. Might have a delivery for me. Maybe I've got Christmas deliveries. Maybe not. Right, let's go, chat. I can't see anyone. I can't know any. I don't know anything. Phone won't turn the right way. I have no idea. I have no idea what's what. I have no idea what's what. Let's see if I got a delivery. No deliveries, I'm sad now. Oh shit. No, we're good. Thought I'd left something in the car. But I actually remembered it's in here. Oh my fucking. Well, hang on. I need to check this as well. Bro, the life of a fucking weirdo live streamer, okay? You gonna stay there? No. You gonna stay? Oh my fucking god. Just stay there, bro. Just stay there, please. Just stay, camera, please. And again, I don't know what's turning the right way. I don't know what looks right. I don't know what's turning the right way. I don't know what looks the right way. And we got this fucking shit now. I have no idea what's going on. Oh my god. Right, by the way, I see Reenie's soft pee, low drag, broken mailman. And the camera is fucked up. The camera's fucked up. Let me turn, let me see what it wants if I turn like that. Let me see how it looks. This is because of my phone, you know. It's still like that. How does it look if I do this? If I do that, it's no different. If I do that, it's literally. Oh my god. Okay, hang on a sec. I need to sort something out. Where is this? Hang on a minute. Let's try it now. Should work now. I'm just seeing if it rotates. Yeah, there we go. Okay, I can't read the chat, but I know you're there. I know Mailman just said good morning. I'm going to get the other phone for the other chat, and we're going to have a little morning. Hang on. I see Dragons now. Hang on. Did Mailman have a disaster stream? Tell me about it. Tell me about the disaster. Snowball's no good anymore. No good for snowballs, bro. No good. Fuck. Fucking freezing cold. At least I can see everything now. But. You can hear the wind. That was maybe a train going. Oh no, actually. I mean, it is a little bit. It's cold as fuck, low drag. It's cold as fuck. I had school play this morning. My youngest daughter's Christmas play was this morning. You ended stream early. What happened? How did you feel? Were you going to die? He said he was going to die yesterday. Broken Mailman was on my stream saying he was going to die. Weren't you? What was the play? It was just like a Christmas play. And they were like, this is how children around the world celebrate Christmas. They did Australia. And like China and Africa and stuff. The Australian one was great. They were like, yeah, we have barbecues at Christmas. And I was like, I know some Australian people. I'm going to ask them. Cheerio, do you have a barbie on the beach at Christmas? According to my children's play, Australian people have a barbecue on the beach at Christmas. Potentially. Potentially, this is what I've heard. Australian people have a barbecue on the beach at Christmas. So I've heard.
I'm also glad I wore this hoodie because look, it zips all the way up. It zips all the way up, this hoodie. And it's fucking cold. Then like, to make it look normal, I've got to like fold the hood a little bit to make it look normal when I'm wearing it like this. You work at the soup kitchen? No, you fucking don't. No, you fucking don't. No, you don't. You're sitting indoors with your belly out, eating turkey, you're lying. No, you fucking don't. Cheerio does not spend Christmas. Cheerio does not spend Christmas in a fucking soup kitchen. There's no way. Don't tell him he's a good man. He's lying. He's fucking lying. He doesn't do that. He spends it indoors like this, sitting with his hands on his belly, taking pictures of his feet to post on Discord, eating pudding. Thank you, mummy! And she brings him the pudding and the turkey and that, and he's going, look. That's what he does at Christmas. And then Juzzy comes home, because he's like, oh, Juzzy's back! And then Juzzy comes in like, hi, Cheerio. He's like, Justin's home. Right. Yeah, don't encourage him. Oh, fuck me. I just wanted to sound cool. And in Speedos, bro, if you worked in Speedos, I bet a lot of people wear Speedos in Australia, to be fair. I bet a lot of people wear Speedos in Australia. Let's have a little bit of music. Let's have a little bit of music. Oh, fuck me. Ugh. Onesie in the chat. Morning, darling. Oh. Like this one, yeah? What about GPM's birthday last night? How was GPM? Was he drunk? Was GPM drunk by the end of his stream? He had like a little bottle of sake. And it was like, what, 15% or something? Drank to soft B. The bottle was like this big. And it's like 12%. It was something. I'll have to re-watch the VOD. 500 milliliters. There was probably more alcohol in the two shots I did with him than there was in like the whole, and then his whole bottle of sake. Oh, good old GPM. Do you reckon he's going to wake up? Today he's going to wake up with a slight headache and he's going to come on stream tonight telling us about how bad his hangover was. He had to what? Not do anything for an hour because the room was spinning. Ah. Oh shit, hang on. Because the room was spinning, bro. Bless his little cotton socks. Hang on. Oh, bro, washing up is like, washing like laundry is endless. There's so much laundry to wash, bro. There's so much. And I'd done loads last week. I was like well on top of it. And then I cleaned some stuff out of my car, like old jumpers. I actually cleaned my car prepping for Christmas and GPM's arrival. But then I basically had my car cleaned in vain. Because he didn't see it anyway. Because he didn't get to experience the car anyway. Oh. But But yeah, I'm gonna. I can't wait for the hangover story later. I can't wait for the GPM hangover story about how he woke up with a, like, you know, he felt like really woozy and whatever. That story is coming. Oh, bro. Really? There's no little bits of. This is irregular. Oh, yeah, I found one. This is amazing. I found one. Oh. Where's Oi when you need him as well? I want to shout at him again about Stalker. I want to shout at him about Stalker Anomaly. Good game, that. I'm seriously enjoying it. I mean, I like all the Stalker games, but they really went to town with this one. As a mod. What song is this? Oh, this one's wicked, bro. We're having Myrtle Avenue play really loud. We're having Floating Points play really loud. And I've got to pick the eldest terror up, depending on when she calls me. Depending on how long the stream goes. Excuse me. I had like a mini hiccup thing. Depending on how long the stream goes. Yeah, I'll chat. Let me show you something. Some lovely ones in here. Oh, bro. Pucker they are. Pucker they are, these ones. G something. G13. Do you know what? The names don't matter. The names really don't matter. The names and all that don't fucking matter. I promise you now. The names and the breed. Oh, yes, this is sativa such and such. Don't matter. All that shit don't matter. Just smoke weed. Turn that minus three into a plus three. I don't know how. I don't control the weather, Eagle. Names matter when you have a selection. They matter when you can walk into a shop and go, oh, I like that one more. Because basically you like the smell. But, you know, for the most part, that shit don't matter. It's all this. It's all weed. Weed is weed. I've had good weed and shit weed all over the fucking world. Ultra sour. Ultra sour. It sounds like a fucking CIA mind control program. Ta-da, darling. Back to work. Back to the grind. Oh. We roll the stems and seeds in what? What do we roll it in? I missed that. What did he say? Were you disparaging my countrymen? Is that what you were doing? Low drag, if that is your real name. We'll have to call him fucking Bendeja. I'm not sure what that means. I used to know a couple of Spanish swear words. I don't now. I don't know any anymore. I'm going to have to tell him to shut up. Galiate! Low drag. That means shut up, bro. But I don't know anything else. I don't know how to say anything else. No, Galiate, I heard. Not Galiente. That probably means something else. No, caliente is... Hot is guapa. Guapa is like attractive for a woman. And guapo is attractive for a man, like handsome. There's another word, bonita. Oh, it's bonita. It's like pretty. But Gagliate is be quiet, I believe. So I've been led to understand. Yeah, muy bonita. Bonita's just used for the women, I believe, right? But guapo is used for the men as well. Like guapo means handsome. Muy guapo. Cheerio eater is no muy guapo. I'm not sure what ugly means. I'm not sure what word ugly is. Cheerio, you're not ugly, I'm joking. Why am I kidding? Why am I adjusting myself to Cheerio? Justify myself, he's not here. Oh, good, stream's bright. Streamer, come back. Don't worry, it'll come back.
Just sit tight. If it don't come back, I'll get angry and swear. If it don't come back, I'll swear.
If it doesn't come back, I'll swear and end the stream. If it don't come back, I'll swear and end the stream. But it's back, so we're good. Oh. Ashtray, bro. Right, I'll have to rewatch. Maybe we'll do that tonight. Maybe we'll rewatch the GPM. We're back, brother. Let me tell you something, brother. Snort, snort Hogan. Bro. That guy's shtick is great. Like, Snort Hogan. Right. Right, hang on, let's find it.
It's like a faucet that's dripping.
This song.
I can't make it stop. And I'm like, damn, my pussy drip is going, my sinuses are inflamed.
Clear your nose. Blow your nose. Tip me.
Clear your throat. Please tip me. Damn. Post nasal drip is a constant. It keeps going. It's like a faucet that's dripping. Damn. Snort. 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 Go. Drip. Snort. Snort. I got the drip. Go.
Snort. Living to me, mate. It's cold. Look, I'll show you living the meme. Snowy. Snowy and cold as fuck.
Have a mute button that every second I'm tapping the mute button just in case I'm going to have to clear. Like, this is what I mean. These dumb kids. This is what it is. It's dumb kids.
Dumb kids want a mute button. Only dumb kids want DSP to have a mute button, bro. Need a bit more sugar in that. Only dumb kids want DSP to have a mute button. It's so hard, isn't it? You've all seen me. It's impossible when I sneeze to mute my mic. Foot pedal would be great. Foot pedal would be great. I believe that some people do use foot pedals. I believe that some streamers do use foot pedals, so I've been told. Did we see the new Hate Army intro? I played it last night. Did you see the new Hate Army intro? Featuring also, I don't know which one's real and which one's not. There was a fake Hate Army. There's a fake one. But there's like a new one. This is it. I love the intro. I love the intro.
Hate Army General saying hate Army shit. Hate Army. Your name is Hate Army?
Hate Army. Or is it Hate Army Watch?
And then the logo comes up. Bro, it's so good. Oh, right. Music back. You could set up a hotkey. He could do anything. He could do anything. It wouldn't be hard. He's too lazy. He would never. He would never. This one's going to blow your minds. No, we don't have that. He would never set it up. Sorry. He's not too inept. He's too lazy. He's not too inept. He's too lazy. You know, he just bought Kat another $300 Xbox. He could have bought the same mic as me that taps to mute. It's problem solved. Problem solved. Problem solved. Yeah, I said that on Ediebot's stream. We raided Ediebot the other day and she used hers and I was like, Edie, I said to Big Al, get this girl a stream deck, please. And she was like, she thinks it's cute. She thinks it's cute holding that stupid thing into the microphone. It's not. It's fucking stupid. I was like, the guy uses one of them. What about the fact that instead of getting a free soundboard on his PC, he had to make either bought or made someone buy him a new noisemaker. He uses what mic? She also uses what mic? What mic? Not the same one as DSP. He ain't got a Shure, like, he hasn't got a Shure what's name mic, handheld blue mic. Edie hasn't got a, has she? I thought she's got one of those big Shure mics, like a podcasty looking mic. I thought she had a podcasty looking microphone. Has she got two then or something? She has both. My little blue microphone served me well one for the time I had it. Sticking it upside down in that thing so I could hold it. My little blue microphone served me pretty well. But then it was time to move on. In complete honesty, for me, that HyperX one's been great. Like, the fact you can make it different colours is just an added bonus. But the HyperX mic has been so sweet for me. Like, it sounds a bit over the top when I'm close to it, but I'm a loud cunt anyway. But it's been so perfect. I've had that over a year now. That's been through two hot tub streams with me, that microphone. That mic's been through two hot tub streams. ASMR, glitter on it, water, loads of shit. That mic is solid, man. If it broke tomorrow, I wouldn't upgrade. I'd buy the same one again. I'd buy the exact same one again. For like someone at my level, it's perfect. And it means no extra leads because I'd have to get a mixer to get a better mic. Like to go up to XLR. Well, the thing is, living the meme, I didn't want to go up to XLR because it meant like a mixer and more leads and stuff. Probably like a couple more leads. So that one's USB, which is why. That one's a USB as well, which makes it a bit easier. Now that I got your back, I'll never let you go. Tune. Tune. just saying. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm not singing along. But my ears are cold. I can feel it. The ends of my ears are still cold. Oh. Oh. If I had living the meme, I thought about how I would rearrange that room. I thought about how I'd rearrange the room to like have the screens better and the PC a bit more viable, but there's just not. It's like a complete redo of the room. I just don't have the space and the sockets and like enough units to put things. It just, because it's my living room, it has to go where it goes. I could move myself in the corner a bit, but it just wouldn't be practical. The PC, like, I'm gonna get a better thing to put the PC on. Well, you got a HyperX headset. Years and years ago, when I was on Xbox, I got sucked into the Turtle Beach craze. I had a pair of, they're actually quite expensive. I had a pair of wireless Turtle Beach headset. I mean, they weren't bad for what they were. I never had an issue with them. The mic on them was a bit crap. Sometimes people would have an issue hearing me. But the headset itself, it's quite a good one. It had like a cradle thing that it sits on. And you plug that into the console. And then, but yeah, I used it for Xbox and stuff. You can use them for PC and PlayStation, all that stuff. It's exactly the same. It's quite expensive. Like, I'm saying quite expensive. This is like 6 years ago or something. 7 years ago. Something like that. But recently, I just got one of those. I say recently again, like 18 months ago. I got one of those SteelSeries things for like 40 quid. That's fine for the few times that I actually use a headset on the Xbox. When I use a headset to play with my mate, which I really do now, because I stream all the time. And he doesn't play, he's not been playing Battlefield. He's been playing Call of Duty, to be fair. So he's a horror games, not really. Every game I play now, I stream. Every game I play now, I stream. To be honest. Every game I play, I stream. So it's rare I use a headset anyway. And when I play stuff off stream, I don't use a headset. I just have a TV. It's not that I don't like it. It's not that I don't think it's fun. I just don't. I'm just not bothered enough to put a fucking headset on, you know? I'm not bothered enough. I probably should. Like, if we was to play Battlefield properly and I was to take it a bit more seriously, I would wear a headset because it helps. It does help because you can hear where the bullets are coming from sometimes. You can hear movement sometimes. Like, I can't hear any of that. I mean, Battlefield is not the same as like something like Call of Duty, because there's so many people and it's a bit more chaotic. But it does make a difference, definitely. It definitely makes a difference if I was to take it a bit more seriously. Yeah, I need the toilet ring vanity. I need the neck phones. The stupid thing about that is that I have my, because I don't wear a thing, I have my PC screen turned up a little bit for the music so I can hear it, and the TV up a little bit. But the echo is minimal. With my mic and that, the echo thankfully is minimal. DSP must be getting echo on his too, bro. I don't understand. Right, I need to take a piss. I need to take a piss so you get a great view. You're gonna get a great view. Look at this. Whilst I have a wee, you're gonna get a view of the fat boy. Look at this. Right, sit tight. I'll be right fucking back. I'm back. That was the Fat Boy. Great view of the Fat Boy. What up, Mr. Lion, how you doing? Oh, itchy nose. I'm not bad. Hang on. I had an itchy nose. Let's try what else we got. What else we got? No. Just got off work. Very nice. Fortunate. Very nice. Sorry. It's chest day today, chat. It's chest today. I've been enjoying the new incline they've got there. I've been doing 80 for 12 on the incline. I'm gonna go up to 90 today. I did 105. I did 105 on the plate loaded shoulder press the other day. 105 kilos on the plate loaded. Just like this. Timmy, how you doing? Nice, I hope you enjoyed. Bro, that girl is, she's, oh. That girl is so mad, isn't she? That girl is something else. That Anne Boleyn is something else. I haven't watched every single thing when you've done stuff about her, but I've watched a bunch of them. She and half strange, bro. She and half fucking weird. Oh. And she's so big. She's so big. She's so fucking big. There's a bit where she's trying stuff on and she's like, this one doesn't quite fit how I want it to. And she turns sideways and it just like, ooh. It's just like, it's insane. Do you know what she reminds me of? When she was there, she's trying on these dresses and there's all these robes and stuff. Do you know what she reminds me of?
A superb athlete and a very...
Thank you for the follow, Mr. Lion. Do you know what she reminds me of? Her arms are bigger than mine. So there's an enemy. There's an enemy in Elden Ring, yeah? There's an enemy in Elden Ring that she reminds me of, okay? Do you want to see the enemy she reminds me of? When she turned, like her stature. Her stature. Did we get a raid from Ice Yamamoto? Thank you for the raid. I must have missed that. But she reminds me of this thing. She reminds me of the Godskin Noble. That's what she reminds me of. Just because she's so round, bro. Like, some people are overweight and some people are really overweight. She's like... It's just like a mass with arms and legs growing out of it. And then she's on there saying about how happy she is she's going to lose weight. And every time I watch him watching her, she's always saying the same things. She's like, oh, I've eaten this, and this is so many calories, and I'm watching this. And she never changes. I don't see her really ever get that much smaller. I've never really see her get that much smaller. She's enormous. She must have some serious health issues. She must have some serious health issues. Yeah, 600, yeah. Yeah, the rolling move. Just go, whoa. Yeah, both. But she's just so big. She's just so big. Like, she's up there, bro. Again, like I said, there's this bit where she's trying on these clothes. There's this one bit where she's like, oh, I bought these cardigans and I bought them too small because I want them to fit a certain way. And I'm thinking to myself, are you fucking sure? What way do you want them to fit as you drape them over your enormous like fat back. It's insane, bro. It's insane. If you were a PT, what would I make her do? Starve herself and cardio. You have a question for me. Suspicious, but I'll allow it. I'll entertain the question. I would make her starve herself. You'll be 22 years old again, but your hair will always be grey, yeah? That, what? Have you never heard of hair dye? Haven't you ever heard of hair dye? I'll just bleach it, bro. Yeah. I'll just bleach it. Look, my hair, I don't know if you know this, but this isn't a natural hair colour. Like, coral pink isn't a natural hair colour. Is that it? Is that the only stipulation? Is that the only stipulation? Grey hair. Yeah, I feel like he has to flesh this answer out again. Do I take all my memories and intelligence? I don't want to be 22-year-old me again. Oh, mate, can you imagine? Can you imagine? You take it with me, yeah, that's fine then. If I take all my intelligence, do I take, what else do I take? Do I get 22-year-old body again? Does my body revert back to 22-year-old, or is my body the same? So I get my 22-year-old body again. So I get to take steroids all over again. That'd be quite good, because I could go back and start even younger. Yeah, juice at 22. Because in my head, I'm like 38, and I'm like, let's go! That would be 250 pounds, yeah. Just sauced out. The thing is, though, if you do too much sauce, your hair will fall out. So then the grey hair problem goes away anyway, because I'll just be bald. I could probably pull it. I wouldn't be bald by choice, but I think I could probably pull it off. I would have no choice if my hair kept thinning. Another tattoo, I think I would tattoo on my top of my head if I was bald. I wouldn't get one of those hair tattoos that people get. Have you seen hair tattoos where people get, like, actual bald people get the hairline and stuff? They get the hairs tattooed, like they've got like a number one or whatever, like a 0.5. They get it tattooed. And some people, when they're thinning or they're receding, they get the tattoo here now and on the top, to basically like cosmetically just hide it. But up close you go, oh, I see that. You'll never get bald. All right, yeah, I'll take it. I'll go back to 22. I'll go back to 22. I'll go back to 22 body, 22 youthful face. The thing is, if it's done correctly, Soft P, it can look okay, but you gotta be good. But people get the transplants now, bro. People get the actual transplants, like they get actual hair transplant where they, I guess, put new hair follicle. I don't know how the transplant works. Bro, it seems like too much aggro. And I guess if it's really hitting your self-esteem, I can understand. But I mean, fuck me. I guess you just have to go with it, wouldn't you? But it'd be funny if I went back to 22-year-old me. Like, 22-year-old me would be hilarious. Imagine 22-year-old me coming on stream. Oh my God. Oh my God, you would all hate me so much. 22-year-old me could meet up with 18-year-old Tevin when he's moving his hat all the time. And he could move his hat and tell me about like all the money he's making and stuff. And I could have long hair and a skateboard and a guitar and tell him about metal music. That'd be great. That'd be great, wouldn't it? Lumpy heads, oh, that's, yeah, when it's all like, the worst is like when it's at the back and their head like, it just looks like sort of skin pushed together. Talking about the music industry. When are we going to get part two? When are we going to get part two? I need the music industry to be exposed. He should do a new video exposing the streaming industry. And he should talk about Twitch and YouTube. People abusing the system, yeah? Lies, deceit, intrigue. There's probably loads of, like, dodgy offers he gets and, like, suspicious stuff going on. There's a documentary. Or he could do a third, Thugging and Loving It. What about Thugging and Loving It, part three? Like present day, 2022. And you go and find all those people from the first two and see what they're doing now. Bro, they always do things like that with documentaries. They always do stuff like that with documentaries. That'd be amazing too. That would be amazing too. Just said. I'm just putting that out into the ether. Another classic bicep track. Just saying. Where's my... Hang on a minute. I feel like we still haven't properly explored this. You go back 22, the age of 22. But grey hair, I mean... That sounds like a good deal. That doesn't sound like it's really... Like there's any negatives at all, except hair, which you can bleach and dye. That doesn't sound like a negative. If you just said you go back to 22, but you have the body of an old man forever... Like, you can be that, you can live again for another 70 years, but your body keeps aging. I'd maybe go, or you go, you have to have the whole body of an old man. That one would give me pause, because if you're 22, but you're like Benjamin Button 22, that's weird, isn't it? That's going to be a weird one. And you're just going to get older. So even though you're like 50, you still feel great. You're like a little wrinkly old man. Bro, no. If I can't take my testosterone and get gains, that sounds like not a good deal. Balding is the worst case scenario. Just gotta, you just, as stupid as it is for me to say, because obviously I go to the gym all the time, but that's like a hobby, but you just gotta kind of accept it gracefully, ain't ya? I mean, look, my teeth are fucked because these were two baby teeth and didn't come through properly, or the top ones didn't come through properly, and I had not the wrong sort of brace, but I chose to do that when I was a kid. Whatever. Just got to deal with it, ain't ya? You can get stuff fixed. I get it. People get really self-conscious about things. It's not like I don't understand that. But with stuff like that and, you know, like that's the face you've got. That's the dick you've got. That's the life you were born into, or that's the... Whatever it is that you don't like. Those are the feet you've got. Gotta get on with it, haven't you? I went to jiu-jitsu with someone that had a webbed toe. I went to jiu-jitsu with someone whose, I think, his third and fourth toes were fused together. It was just like that in the womb. So he had like a little mutant toe. Did webbed toes help? No, but he should have done swimming. It might have helped him swim better. More like... But, you know, who cares? He's a nice guy. Super mutant. That's something out of The Thing. But he's a nice guy. I feel like GPM should have got something better for his food than those awful Rustler's burgers I watched him eat last night. Disgusting. There's definitely some super mutants out there, right? With like extra, like, I mean, there's people with like weird stretchy arms and, oh fuck. But I'm talking about stretching. Ah. Oh, I feel so stiff, man. I can't wait. Do you know what? I can't wait. We got 2 weeks. 2 weeks. Oh, 2 weeks. Decca. 2 weeks. Ah, and we keep going. To think at the start of this year, To think at the start of this year, I was bench pressing the 40 kilos and now I'm doing it for reps for like sets with the 50s. I put 10 kilo on my dumbbell bench press. Soft P, you lost like 60 pounds, you cunt. You've lost like 60 pounds. How much have you lost in total? How much in total have you lost? I know you know. So you were 270 and you're now what? Bro, that is so much. That is so much. Oh, fuck that! Bro, that is so much. Do you know how much that is, Soft Pay? That's like, it's like nearly 90 kilos. That's an insane amount of weight. Just hang on, where is it? What was you, 270 and you was at 188? Yeah. So you lost like 80 kilos. And Living the Meme lost fucking 50, bro. That's a massive amount of weight. Like those big weight plates. Those big weight plates, that's four of those. These weigh 40 kilos each. This is what you lost. My entire selectable dumbbells, the heavy version. This is what you lost. This. Look how fucking heavy this is. Bro, look how heavy these are. Hang on. Look at the effort required to pick this up. You lost two of these. And really still lost 30 pounds. It's all progress. This is what I keep telling you people. There's no destination. There is no, my goal was 175. Even if it was. There's no, my goal was 175. You'll be fine. It'll come back off. There's no goal. There's just doing it. There's no goal, bro. There's just doing it all the time. Did you see that? I went like that, it bounced off. I went to, what's name it, and caught it again. Snappy. So I'm just dancing in the kitchen with you today. Bro, this is like one of my favorite tops. But I can't wear it because it's too cold and the collar's too open. I got another one. I got some other one off Etsy from America. It's like a similar cut, but it's white. And it has a little dude like with sort of semi-jacked arms sitting there with pink hair. And it says like power wear or something like that. Some old 90s top. But he looks like me. The guy on it is like that sitting over the side. And he's got like spiky pink hair. Look, bro. This is my ideal physique, ready? This is my ideal physique. That's my ideal physique. What is it, Cheerio? Cheerio, what are you sneaking around doing this morning? What does Cheerio do all day? Sits in his pants watching Twitch. Like eating ice cream or something. just sitting, eating ice cream, watching Twitch. Waiting for Yazzy Bug to go live. Good evening, my queen. Have you had a nice day? What I would give to be mod in there so I could look at your chat record. What I would give to be mod in her chat so I could look down through your chat record in there. I would love to go. I'd spend a whole stream. I'd spend a whole stream going through Cheerio's chat log on Yazzy Bugs just to see what he says. I would spend the whole stream doing that. Maybe we'll do that one day. Yeah, I should do that with some of my former strange chatters. We could spend a stream going through Proxy's chat log. Oh, poor Proxy. I wonder if he ever watches. I wonder if he ever watches, like I'm not logged in. Poor Proxy, bro. He couldn't adapt. I wish he could have adapted, but he couldn't. He couldn't adapt. Imagine he comes back one day. Never. I don't think ever. But yeah, that'd be interesting. I mean, thankfully, most of the time, he was lovely. He was lovely. He was a very nice, warm human being. He just definitely lived too much of his life online and liked me a bit too much. But he was lovely. And that's why, out of respect, I don't use any of the stuff that he made, except the Ultra Friends logo on one of the screens. That's like a little homage to Proxy, that Ultra Friends logo. That's what it is. It's a little homage. It's like a little thank you note. Do you know what I'm saying? It's going to be there forever. Well, I mean, unless the Ultra Friends explode, which better not happen, bro. We're not going anywhere, okay? We're not going anywhere. Apparently you could be in fucking multiple Twitch teams. What the fuck? I'm not being in another team. I'm not going to be in some other team. Yeah, the only way we're going to explode is we're all going to be propelled into streamer stardom. Maya, how you doing? I'm not being on some other team. Yeah, rocketed to stardom. Jet powered. Where's the charger? I need to charge that, maybe. Maybe. I like this song. Ooh, that's a bit too loud. Might have another cup of tea. I should really have some food. I've got to get back into eating mode. The massive geezers. I've got to get back into eating. Speaking about massive, I've got to get back into eating mode in the next couple of weeks, which basically just means like actually having breakfast. And paying attention and trying to get a little bit more in, even if I am already satiated. Because in order to build more muscle and to more efficiently and effectively use anabolic steroids, you need to be in a calorie surplus. We need to be. So we'll see. But I need to get back into that, like, frame of mind. Which is not easy if you don't, like, Like, I wish I could have, to be fair, Maya can, like, just get proper enthusiastic, can't you? And eat, like, with more regularity. I wish I had a bit more of an appetite, or a bit more of, like, a sort of desire with it like that. I just got well used to, like, being a little bit hungry. You can put food away. I've seen you eat. You can put food away, and you can eat more often and stuff. And a wide variety. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. That's what I'm saying. I wish I had more of an appetite like that. Because if you don't, if you're not that bothered, eating's hard. You need the mass. You're not big at all. You're not big at all. It looks fine on you. Maya has a powerful physique. And she goes to the gym. And she did jiu-jitsu for a little bit as well. And she did jiu-jitsu for a little bit. So there's also that. So don't fuck with her either. You'd like to have some more lean mass. You could get that. You could get it. It's just time. I know what it's like. It's time. Time and consistency. Low appetite. Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. Some people do. So it's just like, again, all of that stuff, they're all genetic components. It's all genetic components. And we just get a random sprinkling of mum's and dad's DNA. Sounded a bit creepy, didn't it? But you know what I'm saying. Chromosomes and that. And it's just luck of the draw sometimes. It's called ghrelin. There's a chemical your body releases, like a when you're hungry. It's called ghrelin. And again, it's widely thought that some people have more or less, or some people can tolerate more or less. Of course you could. Of course you could, Maya. Anyone could. Of course you could. Of course you could. Of course you could. He was a small guy and he was muscular. What ethnicity was your dad, if you don't mind me asking? Just because that also doesn't play a factor, like, specifically, but again, on, like, he's getting old now. Well, that's like, percentage-wise and stuff. Some people are more jacked than others, ethnicity-wise. See, even, and again, even if your dad was jacked and you're similar build, a similar height, it's all genetic predispositions. Imagine if she's just like, really living the meme. Interesting. I just lived here. I'm just boring. I was just here, always. Can we do one more little smoke with the chat? One more. I'll do one more. What time is it? 11:15. I wonder what time pickup's gonna be. Probably about midday. Yeah, we do one more, and then I'll head to pump it up at about 12:00. That's my plan. That's my plan. Lived as civilians in Japan. Pretty fascinating. Especially the culture shock as well. The culture difference, I mean. The culture difference. Bro, why is my fucking stream dodgy on the PC over there? What's occurring? I don't understand this at all. Put some more washing on. This giant pile of washing I've still got to get through. This is a joke. I should have done a laundry stream like you, Maya. I've got a bunch to fold up upstairs and a pile here. Admittedly, some of it's like towels and stuff. After I finish, I won't subject you to laundry sounds. I won't subject you to laundry noises. I won't do it. We'll have one more tea and a chat. By the way, don't let Juzzy finish streaming. No one is allowed to let Juzzy finish streaming because we're going to raid him. If he raids us, we get really angry and I'll like, have to punish him by demodding him or so. Stop him from ending at all costs. At all costs. Oh, I need the charger as well. I need the fucking charger, bro. How much have we got left? 11%. Sit tight, Jack. You're gonna get more music as well, don't worry. Hang on. Right. Saved. We'll probably do some more fucking Stalker later. Why do I like that weird game? I mean, it is awesome. Stalker is pretty awesome. And Frogger liked it, I think. Well, he said he did. It is just awesome. Oh, fuck. Let's do this smaller. That fucking mod is well hard, though. Even with good items, it's stupid hard. Like, stupid hard. But I'm used to it. It won't deter me. I'm sure there's a better place to sit as well. Again, like, the sofa's fine. It's not fine. I probably need a new one of those as well, but fuck it. Imagine being able to get a new sofa. But, yeah. Having the fucking screen where it is, so annoying. I can't have, like, proper spacing. And my feet have to, like, weave between the light and shit. I make all of this work just for you lot. Incredible, I know. Incredible, I know. And another tea. Oh. I still have to get Christmas presents. I still have to go out and get a few more Christmas presents. Like, I've got a bunch of them, but I still have to get some more. Busy and stuff. It's gonna be like all Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday. Gonna have to be slight Christmas overdrive mode. And I like this song. Spider music. But yeah, I do most of it online normally. But I just need a few more bits. I need to go out and look. Like my nan, I've got to get my nan something. Get her like a nice cake or something. She likes things like that. Like some nice M&S stuff. That's a nice shop over here. But I don't know. That's why I've got to go out and look. Instead of just aimlessly browsing Amazon. It's not like I didn't get anything I need off Amazon, I did. Stiff, man. Is this what it's like? Does it just get worse than this now? Does it just get worse and worse than this? Just stiffer and stiffer. Just need a massage. That's what it is. I need a massage. Me and Onesie went, I think, about 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago. It's been. That's why. I know that's why. I don't stretch. And I tell people they should stretch, even though I say to them, I don't, and I should. I should do a little stretching routine. I've said this, in the morning or in the afternoon when I get home or something, I should do a little 10 minute thing every day. And I say it, and I just don't do it. It's hard to make habits. That's why I know it's hard for all of you to like go out for a run. Or do whatever it is that you need to get done or you put off getting done. No, we never do. I mean, occasionally we do. But no, a lot of the time, no, we don't, do we? Or at least we deviate from the path as well. If you have the money to do it, live in the meme. If you have the money and the space, get a nice, decent multi-gym system. That's the best sort of thing for you. Not much. Well, if you don't need a lot, if you're going minimal, you have the space. If you're going minimal, some kettlebells, a pull-up bar, and maybe a dips, like a pull-up bar slash dips would be really good. Don't get dumbbells, get a barbell. I would say get a barbell instead. Are you going to get a bench? Are you going to get a bench as well? Are you going to get a bench? Get some of those selectable ones then and get a bench and then you got everything. Get some of those selectable dumbbells and get a bench because then you have everything. Yeah, perfect. Then you got everything then. Get some of those selectable dumbbells, if you know what I mean. If you know the ones I mean. To be fair, we just looked at Mars, didn't we? Like the ones you can adjust. Yeah, I suppose that's true. I suppose that is true. What are we going to have now? I mean, I kind of like that track, but whatever.
next week. Oh. There we go. Get the selectables. The problem is that you're probably, you won't need super heavy ones, but you'll probably get more for your money out of those selectable ones. Do you know what, Perez? I think you're probably right about that. Because I never really thought that stretching before a workout was a good idea. Because the muscle is not warmed up. There's no blood flow. So I always thought it was a bit weird to do long stretch, to like stretch a muscle and then work it out. That never really seemed to make sense to me. And there is a bunch of people that kind of agree with that as well. But that makes sense. You say, I mean, you might. I did home gym for years. And in the end, you just want... Oh, it depends. It's not like you want... It depends. I suppose it depends how far you go. It gets to a point where you're progressing so much that you need to go to a gym. Because you don't need, but there's time. Bro. I told you not to let him end. I told everyone not to let Juzzy end. Yeah, fuck you. Thank you very much for the raid, Juzzy 51. How did you like Street Fighter 6? How come you were playing it? Is that this cracked version of it? Meanwhile, how you doing? Thank you very much for the raid, Juzzy 51. The wonderful Juzzy 51, yeah? Ah. What you got a copy, did you? Foch, how you doing? Foch, don't give me that. I know how good you are. Swollen Dingus is here as well. I do see you. That's my UK rated pirate radio patter, Dingus. See you, bruv. And Devin, I see all of you. So how did you like it? No, Dingus doesn't play fighting games. You're better than me at this shit. I need your opinion. Dingus, how did he do? Did it look like Juzzy was doing good? Where are you going on this cruise? Was Dingus playing it? Bro, there's so much information coming at me right now. Central America, many locations. Are you going to stream? Aren't you going to do like IRL stream, like when you went to the fair? If you're going around the country... Yeah, when's the face reveal? Home videos for a sub goal. Oh, he's grinching us for a sub goal to show us videos of fucking, like, Dingus on holiday. What are we going to call it? What's going to be your tagline? Dingus Diaries! The Dingus Diaries! I've got it! Dingus on deck! Yeah. You can have Dingus Diaries as well. You can have that in the back pocket for later. Dingus on deck. Yeah. Very nice. Christmas cruise as well. A Christmas cruise. Sorry, by the way, I missed someone. Ivan Drago, how you doing? And Sir Soup, how you doing? Oh, that's disgusting. Yeah, but I do have a background. I do have lights sometimes. Look, I have lights in my kitchen. I do stuff like that. I have green screens and all this stuff. I just do lots of things. Variety in that. Asterisk. Ah. Yeah, the Dingus Diaries. That would be a bestseller. That's when he like. And I'll tell you what that is, Juzzy. That's when he's like 60 and he writes his memoirs. After he's had like a long and storied life of streaming and whatever other weird shit he gets up to at night. When he's 60, he writes his memoirs and he calls it the Dingus Diaries or Diaries of a Dingus. Diaries of a Dingus, yeah? And it'll be like ghosts written by someone. Ghosts written by Almighty Devin. Is that what they call that, a ghostwriter? Yeah. Oh, this one's good as well. Is it an Australian term? I don't know where the term comes from. I'd have heard it more American, to be honest. But it still exists in this country. Yeah, that's it. Just lowercase. Just lowercase. So it'd be like, foreword by Ann Lee. Yeah. Ivan Drago, thanks for the follow. And then there's just going to be pictures of Garfield inside on my such and such trip in 2026. And it's just Garfield. That's what he looks like. It is just literally Garfield with human limbs. That's what the face reveal is going to be. As you propel to stardom. But I still struggled. And I was a fan through thick and thin. Yeah, I can see it. Like I always say, don't forget us little people when you more successful people up there reach the top. Just don't forget us. I know it's really high up there. Just don't forget us. Every now and then, just look down and go, whee! Just a little look, just a little wave is enough. Just a little wave is enough. Just... Hey. Did I say hello to Chalupa, by the way? What do you mean? You could go and visit her. You'd be famous and like swanning around the world. Oh, mate. This could dreams become reality, Dingus. Sometimes. It's true. 2 years ago, I was like, it'd be cool to be a live streamer, wouldn't it? And then 2 years later, I'm there. I'm like, oh my God, I'm a live streamer. You got no one shouting in your face. Any tips? What, for actual self-motivation? It's really hard for me to give people self-motivation tips because that's like, that there is the key. And as no matter how much you tell someone and they know what they've got to do, something's got to change within them. You've got to like either look in the mirror one day or you've got to, whatever it is, say it's someone who's like overweight. They've got to go to the doctor or just something... within them. Like there's loads of little like tips and stuff you can get for losing weight, but what I'm saying is actual motivation to get some structure and consistency is really fucking hard, and you gotta really want it yourself. Yes, exactly, Soft P. That's the only way. I can give you a load of like tips to lose weight and you have to be in a calorie deficit and all that shit's true. But the secret part or the trickiest part is you need that fire inside yourself. people can't really light it for you most of the time. Someone can inspire you. You can watch someone and be motivated by them, but you still have to have it inside and want it. You have to get up every fucking day, or even after work or whatever, 10 at night. I'll go 10, 11 at night. Even though you want to sit there and eat or do whatever, you have to fucking do it. You have to want it and you have to do it. And that's the hardest fucking bit. It's way harder than when you're actually at the gym doing the workout. If you were sitting there in your front room like this, just eating, blah, and I went, and you were at the gym was empty, you're there at the machine, like, well, what the fuck? And you'd be like, well, I'm here, I might as well train. And then we went, and you're back home, it'd be a bit easier, wouldn't it? If we did that 10 times, 20 times, you'd be like, oh, this is all right, I just sit, I just chill. And then slowly, you'd get more motivation. You'd be like, no, I can go myself and just see what I'm saying. You have to build that inside yourself. You've got to want it. You can do it. You've obviously got to work around paying your bills and stuff as well. And you haven't got to be a psychopath. And again, it's not like the training and all that stuff is basic. Like, it really is. I know it might not sound like it is. And I know there's loads of techniques and blah, blah, blah. But in reality, as DSP likes to say, the training itself is fucking basic. It's the same basic moves. It's just repetition. Once you learn how to do them correctly, and it's not like there's variation and there's other things you can do, but basically, once you get them all down and you just start adding bits of weight and you go out for a run, all that stuff is pretty basic. It's hard because you have to keep doing it again and again and again and again for days and weeks and months and fucking nearly 10 years. Like, literally 10 years. It's fucking hard. No, 9 years? Whatever, it doesn't matter. The point is years. You don't need to do it every day. You don't have to be a complete psycho. But you gotta want it. Same as you wanted anything. Same as you're motivated to, I don't know, read a book or watch a fucking film or go out with girlfriend or boyfriend or whoever the fuck. You've got to want to do it. You've got to want to work out and lose your belly fat or get bigger biceps or whatever it is that you want. You've got to want to have that. You've got to want it badly enough that you're going to change your own behaviour patterns in order for you to achieve it. Obviously, some things are unreasonable. Like, if someone's super overweight and they're like, I want to lose it all in 6 weeks because I've got a wedding to go to and I want to fit into this tiny little suit, that's not going to happen. But you just got to want to commit. And no, it's going to take fucking ages, most likely. Most likely it's going to take fucking ages. What the fuck? Oh, you like this one, yeah? You can have this one a bit more. What? I'm calm. Drinking will help a lot. Again, there's obviously other stuff you can do. You've got to, like, eat less and you've got to watch what you eat. And obviously, most of us know all that stuff. Yeah, I was actually there for that part because I had like school play and stuff this morning. But I was watching when I was... when was I watching? Was it in between? I can't remember, but whatever. I was there for that part. I remember you saying, like, DSP is talking shit because you have plenty of time to react to the drive impact. Yeah, that's what he'd say to you. Also, the chat's not updating on this. Yeah, but I was there for that part. No. That's bad. It will be kind of funny once it's out and people start to learn the game and people start to beat the shit out of him on it. And that'll be funny for me, even as someone, again, as I say, that really knows very little about how to actually play them. I'm going to get it. It's on the Xbox. I can get it on the Xbox, which is nice. Bro, I need to... This app is not having it. What the fuck? Right, let's see if it resets. Fuck. But yeah, it's on the Xbox. So that's nice. I hope my stick will work with it. It probably will, right? I don't see any reason why not. I'm sure when I bought it, it said PlayStation, Xbox, whatever. It's just like, insert generic joystick here. I'm sure it'll be fine. I'll get GPM to bring me one over. I'll be like, bring your stick, GPM. We disinfect it first. But yeah, I'm going to get it and suck on it. But it's going to be funny enough. He wants to get a new stick. Yeah, I'll have the salty old one. I'll just spray paint it completely pink. I could do that with that one. Just buy a can of like sparkly pink spray paint. That's what I started doing with a bunch of my weight plates, spraying them pink. But the paint was fucking too, not too expensive, but I just needed loads. I just needed loads. No, GPM. GPM. I see pictures of like a load of where people customising that. It looks cool as fuck. It definitely looks very nice when they're all like customised and they've got separate like the special buttons. Not special buttons, but like the different buttons and all that shit. Very cool. And people obviously do like, they fucking spray them or do stickers or vinyls, whatever the fuck they put on them. Yeah, very cool. I remember when there was like a bit of a craze. I never got any, surprisingly enough. But there was a fucking craze for a little while. There might still be now. No, there's probably not now. But there was a thing with Xbox 360 faceplates. Maybe the whole case, but I'm pretty sure definitely at least the faceplate. People, you would... Loads of companies made, like, custom ones. Because you could take it off. And you would have, like, different colours. Or they were, like, definitely anime ones and all sorts of shit. I remember that for a little while. To be fair as well, Microsoft, I don't know if they still do it now. They went through a thing where you could basically have a custom built Xbox controller with like basically anything you wanted. They might even still do that now. But you can just build the controller and have it any fucking color you want. Any color that all you can change all of the buttons, the pattern on the controller, all this shit. I mean, it costs you like probably twice what the controller normally costs. Yeah. And you can like, I don't know, you can do anything after the faceplates. Yeah, it makes sense. I don't know how much money they're making off that. They must be making something. I would do it if I was more frivolous. I actually do need a new controller because my right bumper is fucked and is sticking because I've mashed it so much. Do you know what that is as well? Because the right bumper is like Attack in Elden Ring and Dark Souls in there and Sekiro. In all of those games, the right bumper is the attack button. I'm just fucking mashing it all the time. So it's marked. So I have to get a new one. And the other controller has got like a little lean on the stick, I'm sure. That's why I don't use it. Because I've got another one. I was like, I'm sure that one's fucked as well. I should get one of those weird, what colour did DSP get? It's like a weird maroon one, right? Is it supposed to be red or something? I guess it maybe it was his camera made it look a bit shitty. But then again, I fuck around with my camera and it looks crazy all the time, so who cares, I guess. Who cares? Right, what's the time? 10 to 12. Plenty of time to go to the gym. Just as we were talking about fitness and motivation and all this shit, there's plenty of time for me to go to the gym. It's still how cold. Let's look at the weather, lads. It's 1 degree. Oh, it's gonna go to, at sunset it's gonna be -2. And in the dead of night it's gonna be -4. Oh God. And it was -4 this morning as well. It was fucking awful. Oh bro, it was so awful. I hate it so much when it's this cold. And you just sit in the car, the car's completely frozen. The crack in my windscreen like went from like this big to this big, obviously because of the heat change or whatever. Like I looked and went, what the fuck? I'm gonna have to get that done now. It literally was like this to like the middle of where I am. And now it's like here. It's mental. But yeah, just sat in the car, first thing. It's all frosted over and you're just in the car like waiting for the heat to like defrost it. Fuck getting out and scraping the thing off. Fuck that. And it's taking longer because the engine's fucking cold. And we're all sitting in there waiting to take him to fucking school and that. And just like, for fuck's sake, just sitting in my fucking coat and my jumper just, ugh. I hate it so much. Yeah, but it takes ages to warm up because the car's been sitting all night and it's freezing. So I have to sit there slightly revving the engine, like, come on. Right. This is also a great song. Right, we've got I see someone. I've actually got two people on my list playing Street Fighter 6 right now. One is Bitch Pudding. I think this is one of someone from Hungdiety's stream. Drag Queen plays Street Fighter 6. And then we've got Red Gambit. He's playing Street Fighter 6 as well. But Bitch Pudding, I've never actually been to their stream either. But they've been to mine, so let's not raid them. Let's not raid them. Yeah! Let's do... I forgot then that you play Street Fighter as well. Am I streaming later? Yes. Yes. I am streaming later. My mate is coming over tonight. I have the, I've got some stuff to do. But I, yeah, I'll stream later on tonight. Thank you all for hanging out. And sitting with me on this cold winter morning. Now I'm gonna go and shower and go to the gym and tidy up and do it all over again. So have a nice day, or night, afternoon, morning, whatever the fuck. I'm sorry, I know. I know it's devastating. I know it is devastating. It is devastating. But there's always, not even tomorrow, there's always this evening. How much are they selling codes for? What, on eBay and stuff? For this beta again? Quickly tell me, because the stream's going to end. They're selling codes on eBay or whatever. So many people getting ripped off, bro. He bought it for 100, what? Right, right, it's right. See you later.